Hi, I'm Isabelle MacNeil, and what's your name?
I'm Boris. I'm a professor of marine biology here at Dalhousie University.
These plastic kits that are going to be available for people, when are they going to be available for use?
So the kit is available now at our website, but we're going to add to it. So what we have there right now is just the basics. For example, we at Ocean School, we're providing a virtual reality experience where you can be a marine creature, and in virtual reality you can look around and experience the ocean as you're swimming in a sea of plastic, and you're really feeling what that's like, and so you're forming a different understanding of what that's like, how plastic actually affects marine creatures.
That's really cool. And how does the plastic get into our oceans?
Well, the problem with plastic is it swims and it lasts a long time. So when it's discarded anywhere in the world, it often finds its way into waterways. And from that, it goes into watersheds, down into rivers, and into the ocean.
When I say water pollution, what do you think of that?
Plastic in the ocean.
People throwing, like, bad things, like plastic, garbage in the water.
I think that's a very bad thing because there's also animals that live in the water, and if there's pollution in the water, then they could get sick by that.
I think of like plastic bags and water bottles and the endangered species in the water.
As kids, how can we solve this problem from making sure that there is less plastic in our waters and our beaches?
Yeah. There's a variety of things that kids or anyone really can do. It starts with your personal habits. So we're using a lot of plastic in our personal lives. And I think it starts with learning about which kind of plastics can be recycled and which can't be, which ones are toxic and which are not, and really trying to eliminate the use of single-use plastic, things like straws, for example, or single-use plastic bottles that are for which we have good alternatives. I can just drink from a cup, or I can use a reusable bottle. And that plastic will never be produced for me, and it will never end up in the ocean.
Do you use a reusable water bottle?
Yeah. You can just refill it all the time, and it's better for the earth.
Do you recycle at home?
Yes. We just put recyclable stuff in a bag, and we give it to a couple of people, and we get a bit of money.
I was just on a kayak trip, and on that 3-day kayak trip, I picked up every single piece of plastic I found and stuffed it into my kayak. And that's plastic that will not kill a turtle or affect a seabird. That's plastic I can bring to the recycling, and then it's made into something useful rather than affecting marine life.
We have picked them up before, and I have seen a lot of people with garbage bags, and they bring them just to pick them up for fun.
How, in with this kit, can you ensure people to make sure that they can do it and they will recycle and try to make a difference so there's less plastic?
Sure. So we can't force people to do anything, of course, but just you and I having this conversation, I think, already adds to the consciousness that's out there. We're talking to a number of viewers right now, and those may talk to their friends. And seeing an online resource that's interactive and interesting and up-to-date and science-based, I think really helps with getting people getting the facts right and really giving them very concrete things to do. So my hope just is that this turns into a global movement, a phenomenon, many more people in Canada used to smoke. We didn't used to wear seatbelts. There were a lot of things that people used to do or were not used to that we're now doing. And I think we can do the same with plastics. It just takes a little bit of mindfulness. And for that, you need to know the facts. Other than that, you're not aware of the problem.
Thank you for your time and answering all our questions. It was
a great interview, and I thank you for your interest.